And welcome to this week's episodes of TWD, The Walking Dead. We are back, and we'll discuss seasons 12 and 13 tonight, so don't go away, and we'll be right back.
Fire trucks everywhere. People from the neighborhood. It was my house they were there for. That was my mom in bed. Burnt down to nothing. That's the hard part. Yeah, she's just gone.
I may be the one walking away. You're the one that's leaving. Again.
She wasn't sorry. That's her. That ain't her. We ain't dead. Whatever happened, happened. I'm bleeding out for you. Let's start over.
Jesus said that my world was going to get a whole lot bigger.
Your world's about to get a whole lot bigger.
Well, we found that world. We found each other. That bigger world is ours by right.
Paul Robia. But my friends used to call me Jesus.
We used to be explorers. The whole world is ours to rediscover.
You ever see him do this before?
No. Never.
Just milling around. That's not
normal.
No, it ain't.
This wasn't a normal route.
What do you mean?
It's already been through here twice. It's looking for me. They were whispering to each other. The walkers are involved.
We're stronger together.
That doesn't help us. Our only reality is to avoid a fight. Get him out of here. Go! I got this! Shoot!
Jesus! Come on!
For running into you. I'm gonna go now. This is the next world. I hope it's good to you guys.
You hardly handle God.
Madness.
Okay, we are back on TWD. This is Denise Harris with you tonight. Are you not excited about this season? I mean, seriously. What the hell, Henry? You're an idiot. I am sorry. I'm going to call him Sam Jr. because, wow, he needs to just be stay tied to that tree. So we're going to get into season 9, episode 12 first. Guardians. So let's get going on that. Of course, you know, Lydia back with Alpha. And Alpha doesn't leave any water behind the bridge, under the bridge. And she starts asking her about intel, of course. And it offers up an up-close and personal look at two different leaders who share one thing. They're willing to do almost anything necessary to keep their people safe. Michonne wrestles with the secrets that have been kept from her and some serious back talk from Judith. You gotta love it. She's a feisty little thing. I love her. Then there's Alpha, who rules the whispers with an iron fist and definitely gives new meaning to tough love. Bam! Especially with her daughter. Yeah. They have to both deal with serious crisis of confidence. Reveals rather, of course, divergent approaches to problem solving. And as unrest grows, Michonne relies on the will of the people. Alpha prefers a less democratic solution. And, of course, all the while, Henry continues to be a dumbass. So, yes, he does. He drives me absolutely bonkers, let me tell you what. They should have left them both behind as far as I'm concerned. But, anyway, and she talks about, Lydia talks about their farmland, supplies, and weapons. But she leaves out some important stuff. Like their dealings with other communities. She didn't mention the kingdom at all. It kind of surprised me. I'm not sure where this girl is yet. I'm really not. I don't know if she's confused or, you know, she's playing. I don't know. Don't know yet. And Alpha's disappointed over her lack of intel. And Lydia asks if that's the only reason she came for her. What a stupid question, Alpha says. Of course. Duh. And, of course, we go to Alexandria. Michonne is dressing down her council for keeping her in the dark about their radio mission. She was not happy. Father Gabe argues they should be more open to new communities. But Aaron steps up. And I'm surprised. He really takes Michonne's side in this. But Aaron reminds him about the whisperers and how they should trust Michonne's discretion. And here comes Sadiq. Michelle, your favorite character. We don't know where he is. Either at this point. I don't know. He just showed back up. Ta-da, ta-da. And I'm not sure where he stands yet. We don't know anything about him, really. So, but he argues that Michonne's not always right. And her decision to cut ties with the kingdom proves it. Michonne draws a hard line and asserts she's not willing to sacrifice her people to save the kingdom. And later on, Father Gabe briefly laments his problems at the console with Rosita. Rosita, I don't know what the hell you were thinking. I don't know. But anyway, he doesn't elaborate, so she brings up her pregnancy, saying she wants him to stay despite carrying Sadiq's baby. Now, what a twisted romance, right? Okay. Now we're back to Henry. He's trying to catch up to the whispers, but it's kind of the whispers caught up to him. He thinks he's slick, right? He's watching them from, and I put in quotes, a safe distance. A whisperer comes up behind him and tells him to put down his staff. He knocks him out. Hoo-hoo, he thinks he's tough, don't he? But who comes along? Beta grabs him from behind and just lifts him up and throws him at Alpha's feet. You gotta love it. And he says, of course, Beta says he's been tracking Henry for a while, but Henry's been tracking them for longer. Yes, gotta love Beta, Ryan Hurst. Oh, yeah. Gotta love Beta. He is huge. Wow. Anyway, Alpha questions him as Beta's got him in the slammer. He's going to break his arm. Henry relents, of course, and reveals he came to alone to get Lydia. And Lydia comes up, calls him stupid, and cold cocks him right in the face, which I don't know if this girl's playing. I don't know what she's doing yet. Alpha laughs and decides to bring him along. Henry, you're so stupid. We cut back to Alexandria. Meanwhile, in Alexandria, of course, Eugene shows Gabriel his risk-reward calculations. Gotta love it. If he should stay with Rosita or not. There you go. Graphs and charts and whatever, right? Father Gay brushes it off, but Eugene warns him he'd be a fool to let her go. Would he? I don't know. Rosita, you boggle my mind. We go back to the woods, and Alpha reminds her that this guy just risked his life to save her. She talks to Lydia about Henry, you know, and reminds her this guy just risked his life to save her, so she has to be lying. And of course, we get this peek at the Whisperer camp, which is full of people not wearing their walker skins. We see them just sitting by, in the dirt, playing in the dirt, making masks. So we see a day in the life of the Whisperers. And then Alpha instructs Beta to get Lydia a new skin, of course. Then we cut back to Michonne, and she's in Negan's cell. This was kind of interesting. It's like, Michonne, chill, woman. She's really been harsh lately. I don't know. And she asks him why he came back. And he tells her how he could have bashed everyone's head in at their homes, but chose not to. You know, he tells her, I was in your house. So Michelle surmises he actually tried to give the outside world a shot, but was spit back out when he found there was nothing there, of course. He confirms her theory and suggests she start trusting him if she doesn't plan to kill him. I mean, what are you going to do with this guy? Keep him in the cell forever? I don't think so. But she's not buying it, but he suggests he could help her with the console problems. Of course, she shuts that crap right down, and then she looks up and sees Judith watching them from the cell window. So, we're back to the Whisperers. Connie and Daryl hunt. There goes Connie and Daryl out to get Henry. I'd say leave him out there. He's being stupid. But they go out and hunt for Harry and realize that in their tracks, Connie kind of said that they found him. They found him first. So, and at the camp, Beta skins a walker head for Lydia's new mask. Alpha taunts Henry some when the two of her own approach, which is kind of bizarre. I love that. I love that scene. They kind of, she's by the stream and she hears him mumbling about, you know, that she made a bad decision. She could have gotten him killed. So, you got to love Lydia, though. How did she get all that clean, fresh clothes and everything? She was in a cell. Did they give her those clothes? Wow. Must have been a Gap store nearby. But anyway, and it's a real party hanging with the Whispers, as we saw. They whisper, dig in the dirt, sit in the dirt, and stare at a dirty stream. So there you go. And Alpha hears him near the stream. She goes by there and she hears him. She could have got us all killed. So, and it's pretty clear that Lydia's not only scared of her mom, and also still angry about a recovered memory of her father's murder. So that's kind of an insight as to our sneak peek into the Whisperers camp. Anyway, you have Michonne still talking to Negan. He makes an appeal for trust, of course. Well, maybe he should have started without, maybe he should have waited till later to say he could have bashed their heads in, but hey, you know. Then she sees Judith out of the cell window. And Michonne confronts Judith, who's her usual smart-ass self, and I love her for it. She's a feisty little thing. I love it. Definitely Rick's daughter, right? When told that Negan's not her friend, she zings, well, obviously, you know. And they're back and forth whether Negan is capable of changing. And little Miss Grimes gets sent to her room for speaking too much damn truth to her mom. I love it. She is so great. She is so great. I love her. She's like, well, you know, people don't change. And she's like, you did. So, and but yeah, she has. I'm just not. Oof. And then we're back to the whisperers. Alpha Taunt Center, while two of her own approach her to question why they gave up two people for her daughter. I don't like the math. The man whispers, you gotta love it. Alpha reminds him she did it for intel. Still, he issues a challenge for her leadership role. Ooh, not good. You knew this was not going to end well, right? Alpha laughs in his face and Beta grabs the man from behind and holds a knife to his throat. You're changing the rules again, the man says calmly. Okay, Alpha does confirm he has the right to challenge her. She's busy circling the woman at this point. She's just staring at her, and this woman's like ready to pee her pants. But she also has the right to defend it. She turns her attention to a woman and suggests it's actually her who wants to be Alpha, not the man. Of course. The woman tells Alpha she failed everyone by putting them in danger. Alpha tells her that her people voluntarily follow her because she does keep them safe. She's talking to her, and you can see what her hands are doing. She wraps a wire around that woman's neck, and pop, there it goes. Her head pops off. Of course, being the leader that she is, she holds it up to her people. As Henry looks on in horror, he probably needed a new change of underwear at that point. Then she hands that head over to the man, tells him crying is for the weak, and guts him. Gotta love Alpha, straight and to the point. Then we're back with Michonne and Judith, of course. You know, and she's questioning Judith why she was spying on him. And, you know, she's there to see Negan, revealing she sometimes talks him out of sympathy. And Michonne tries to calmly explain why that's a bad idea. And Judith is telling her, he listens to me. Michonne firmly demands she not go near him because he's a monster. And if he got out, he would continue to be a monster. And Judith reminds her, guess what? He did get out and he wasn't a monster, proving he has changed. And then, of course, we have Michonne saying, people don't change. And Judith is like, you did. Michonne is just speechless. She's ready to, I don't know what, and sends her to her room. Way to go. When all else fails, let the truth get you mad. Okay. Anyway, we're back at the Whisperer camp. Lydia shows Henry. She still has the necklace he gave her, signaling she secretly supports him. But does she really? I don't know with this chick. I really don't. She didn't tell the whole truth with Daryl and Henry, but she didn't, not telling the whole truth for her mom. I don't know. I don't know what the thing is. And then Alpha tells Beta about the time before the apocalypse when she hit Lydia hard for almost suffocating in a dry cleaning bag. She tells him, you have to do whatever it takes to protect what you love. And Beta's like, we need to be ready when they come for the boy. Gotta love him talking. They both agree Henry can be useful, and they need to find out if Lydia truly has feelings for him. And the Whisperers draw actual walkers. Well, she told Lydia, she throws her the knife and says, Alpha tells Lydia, kill him. She's safe from that because the bodies of the people they just killed, actual walkers are coming. So, save the day for Henry. But anyway, they both agree Henry can be useful, and they draw actual walkers to the bodies. As Daryl and Connie, they're watching nearby. And then we're back to Gabriel and Eugene. And Gabriel follows Eugene's advice and visits Rosita to talk things over. Michonne talks to Aaron to announce she has decided to let the council send a delegation to the kingdom's fair. And Aaron pushes back, but Michonne says, you know, he's like, you're right, you shouldn't, da-da-da-da-da. Michonne says the people should be allowed to decide for themselves. And Aaron's like, I hope we don't regret this. Which, you know, with those words that they're going to. And later, Alexandria starts preparing a caravan of food and supplies to send it to the kingdom for the fair. We don't know what happened. Hopefully we'll find out exactly what caused this rift between the communities. Because they should still all be united, if you ask me. They would be so much better off. But, you know, we don't know what happened in between there. Anyway, that night, Beta takes Henry to Alpha. She makes Lydia pick up the knife and tells her to kill Henry with it to prove what side she's on. You know, Mama don't quite trust her either. So, Alpha warns her not to be weak like her father. And if she doesn't kill him, Beta will kill them both. Real simple. And all of a sudden, another small herd of walkers shows up and begin eating. And I love it. They begin eating the unmasked whisperers. Woohoo! Alpha and the others quickly put on their masks, and Henry tells Lydia they have to go. Save the day. The walkers saved the day for Henry, that's for sure. Daryl and Connie arrive. Disguised as whisperers, they have the masks on so they could blend in. They're there to rescue Henry. They grab Henry, and there's Henry. He grabs Lydia, and the four of them escape. I think they should have just left them both there, but what did I think? And that was kind of the end of it. The four of them take off. Not a good thing, Daryl. Why would you do that and risk, if anything, that's going to cause this conflict with the Whisperers and Alpha? So what did you think of this week's Walking, the episode before, episode 12? And the ending differed from the comics. What do you think is going to happen next? Let me know what you think. Henry getting on my last freaking nerve. And who cares about Gabe and Sadiq and Rosita at this point? Really, that's kind of a moot point if you ask me. I don't know. Call me silly. I just don't think it's relevant to anything going on. I could be wrong, but I don't think so. Would you live like the Whisperers do? The Whisperers, yay for you for your method approach to your roles. Even with no other walkers around, they shuffle around the woods like the dead. And if you notice Lydia, she can't help but walk like them either. So, we have that going on. I mean, it's just they're into it. They don't have shelters. They don't have it because the dead don't. So there you go. Some people say, why do they need some big festival to hook up the kingdom with badly needed food and supplies? Can't they just cut a deal? No, because there's that rift there, and we don't know why, what happened with Hilltop Alexandria and the kingdom. We just don't know what happened. I have a feeling Maggie had something to do with it, but hopefully we'll find out. And if you, here's kind of a spoiler, I saw Maggie's not done yet. So, per Lauren Cohen. So there you go. So I think it's important. I think they all should have been getting along, but something did happen in that time period, in that time jump, that they all dissented, more or less. What do you think about Negan? He's been in that cell for how long now? I mean, come on. He could have escaped. He could have not come back, but he did because there's nothing out there for him. And I have a feeling they're going to be using him and need him down the road here. And that romance quadrangle, whatever. At least one of these four is going to die before the season's over. Who do you think is going to die out of them? Rosita wants Gabe to stick around. She's carrying Sadiq's child. Eugene's head over heels. Get a grip here, people. That's like a soap opera within the drama, please. God. I don't know. But Gabriel's got to admit he's got a kick-ass chick there. And she don't care about his eye. So there you go. What more do you want? And you see Eugene looking on. Oh, you feel so sorry for him. Dumbass Henry. Wow. I don't know. And here's a good description of what we saw as far as Whisperer Camp. He saw the mask shop, of course, where they were, you know, making the masks. Game carving station. And, of course, a bunch of dirty people sitting around with nothing to do. So, there you go. I think a lot of, I don't think it's all purely out of fear. I think they really believe that to survive, that this is what it's coming to. You have to survive, you got to be like they are. So, and you got to love the mask. So much craftsmanship there. Don't you love it? And, of course, Alpha's creeping Henry out to no end, and I love it. Because, Henry, you're so stupid. You deserve it. She's walking all slow and motoring to your mouth. The weak die like nature intended. You got, I love her. She is doing such a great job, and she was really creeping people out off the set. it was great. But when she cut her head off with that wire, I'm like, whoa, look what? And then guts the guy. So there you go. But I don't think Daryl and Connie actually expected Lydia to be with them again, which is gonna, you know, could be their downfall. And there's no way Alpha's letting go of her daughter that easily. And you don't, do you really think the Whisperers won't crash the fair? Yeah, Zeke's party is going to be a whopper. That's for sure. Okay, we're going to take a quick break, and then we'll start with episode 13. So don't go away. And we'll be right back with that. Oh, and just to let you know again, as always, that TWD is sponsored by King's Cannabiz. Thank you for your sponsorship. It is most welcome. So, guys, don't go away. We'll be right back.
What you got going on? High nose, eyes closed, holding on. And I don't want another day to break. Take off, steal off. Night away. yourself on me. Got in store for me. Keep those eyes closed next to me. And I don't want another day to break. Take all, steal all. Night away. Warm shadow. Warm shadow. Won't you kiss yourself on me?
Welcome back to TWD. Hope you're ready to discuss this past Sunday's episode called Chokepoint. And this is an interesting. I really enjoyed this one. Of course, you know, they escape through the woods. And We're waiting for the game-changing devastation, a threat to shake things up with the Whisperers. And this episode really gave a burst of adrenaline from a one-on-one hand-to-hand brawl between Daryl and Beta to show what they're both capable of. You gotta love it. Beta ends up giving chase to the escaping Lydia and, of course, her co-conspirators after the chaos at the base left multiple whispers dead. Do y'all know, did y'all get what Guardians meant? Anybody out there? Okay. When they consider the Walkers their Guardians, okay, the Whisperers do. Beta goes to one of their own, who is slowly bleeding out, you know, from a bite, of course, to comfort him in his transition to becoming a Guardian. So there you go. So he's already showing a difference in how he feels than Alpha. Okay, she rules with the Iron Fist or Gera or whatever you want to call it. And Daryl, of course, blames Lydia for getting him into this mess because they were there to rescue Henry. Not Lydia, but Henry grabbed her. He's a dumbass. Back at the Whisper, Beta tells one of his people to find Lydia or else they'll all walk with the Guardians. So now you know what the Guardians means. And back at the Kingdom, it's nearly finished prepping for the fair. Nabila tells Carol this is everything they fought for. She notices Jerry Bruce and without his armor after returning from a supply mission. And he tells Ezekiel his patrol got jumped and robbed on the road by a group called the Highwaymen. Oh, here we go. Multiple. And, you know, and this is probably, I would think, more true to the an apocalypse than anything. You're going to have your groups that are just out for themselves, period. They'll get what they want and they'll do what they want to get it. They're all not going to be, oh, let's all get together and have a party, yada, yada. No. But they're called the Highwaymen. They gave them a note warning anyone traveling to the fair will be turned back unless they pay their toll. And Ezekiel decides they should fight these marauders and instructs Jerry to gather all their fighters. I love Jerry. He's so awesome. He's so great. You gotta love it. You gotta love it. But back to Beta a little bit more. He already, we know he kind of feels different than Alpha. The kind of person who hits her daughter in front of a group. Beta has an emotional connection to members of the community. At least it seems that way now. He looks after them. And it's a glimmer of humanity that maybe helps explain Lydia's connection to them. I don't know. I don't know. I think, I don't know about her. I just don't know. And, of course, Daryl's questioning her, of course, you know, don't trust her, whatever. Henry, meanwhile, he's lost in a haze of hormones and love, I guess, rambling, oh, they'll run away together to other parts of this open world without any consideration for, you know, his family and community. Oh, the delusional young, right? You got to admit it. And in time of an apocalypse, he's very annoying. He's just annoying, Sam Jr. Henry's parents and the one he's totally disregarding. They haven't a clue what the hell's going on, of course. I like the awe moment at the fair. I love it. Because they had a memorial statue of Shiva. Oh, I was like, oh, isn't that cool? But they have problems of their own. Of course, they were accosted by a group outside known as the Highwaymen. Their armor, weapons, and supplies were taken, of course. And this group, unknown to the pages of Robert Kirkman's Walking Dead comics, they're not in it, call themselves the Highwaymen. They claim the roads surrounding the kingdom belong to them. And where did these people come from? I don't know. And if they don't forego a crap ton of supplies, anyone attempting to journey to their fair will be turned away. This is the group behind the mysterious symbols tagged to the back of a street sign in the last episode. Remember, we were all looking at it thinking that was a whisperer sign. No, this is a highwayman sign. So we got these yahoos to deal with now, too. It's an arrow pointing towards a straight line, signifying a road heading towards the horizon. So there's an explanation for that. There you go. Diane mentioning rumors of stray saviors wandering in packs around the area. It could be Jed and his followers. But no, we know better, right? We know what Carol did. Carol shoots that down and she lit them all on fire. Remember? Gotta love her. of course, King Zeke's plan is to attack first, ask questions later. I kind of agree. But Carol's the one urging the peace talks. And they're like, well, if they don't want to talk, we'll just kill them. You got to love her. She's just, you know, okay. Don't want to talk? Bye. We'll just kill you. Be done with it. I guess the highwaymen, they could have killed Jerry's group, but they didn't. They could have been more life-threatening in their ransom demand, but they weren't. The whole point of this fair is to bring the hilltop, Alexandria, and the kingdom back together. Oceanside, of course. So, and are they the kind of people who will kill instead of compromise? Ezekiel kind of points to it that they are the latter. So it's interesting to see. It's like, where did these people come from now? Well, they weren't in the comics. Michelle, I think you might be able to shed some light on it. I wish you were here. So he tells Jerry to gather all their fighters. Okay. While on the road, Magna's group clears a tree from their path as Tammy tells Earl how happy she is to have the baby. Kelly lets Tara know she's worried about Connie, but, you know, she and Magna, sure, she's fine with Daryl, of course. And speaking of, Daryl's team devises a plan to use an office building as a means of separating the dead from the living. Lydia warns him Alpha's going to send Beta, who's their best fighter. And Daryl's like, we'll kill him first then. Well, fine. Jerry and Carol, of course, scope out the highwaymen community while King Zeke laments the violence they have to resort to. And, of course, Carol's like, we'll talk to him first, and if that doesn't work, they'll kill him. Real simple. Daryl's group prepares for battle in the building, which was very cool, by the way. And Connie and Daryl argue how they should proceed. And Connie says they have more to lose than Lydia, which is absolutely true. I personally toss her out the window. Here, take her. Go away. But of course, I actually, Daryl's right. It is kind of Lydia's. It's more Henry's fault, too, for doing all this, going after her. Dear God, I mean, really? King Zeke, Carol, and Jerry infiltrate the base, and a mysterious man informs them this meeting is for the king alone. Of course, they disagree, and the man asks if they have his toll as his people approach with their weapons drawn. He suggests they use King Zeke as ransom when suddenly the kingdom fighter grabs the man's people from behind. Zeke draws his sword and says he's prepared to fight for what they've created. Then he offers the man a job to clear his roads for him in exchange to access for the kingdom of the fair and the fair. The man laughs in his face and draws Jerry's sword, telling them they'll have to do better than that. Carol then asks when the last time they've seen a movie, and he just looks at her like, seriously? What the hell? Okay, Henry, oh God, I really cannot stand this guy. I really cannot. He drives me totally insane. Okay, I want to kill him off. I don't know. So now we know what that symbol meant. It didn't have anything to do with the whispers, and this group is just out of the blue. I don't know. And the there's a cowboy played by Angus Sampson, and he's kind of he leads them, the highwaymen. And when Carol mentions they have a movie theater, and he goes, "Seriously?" He was being serious. Like, they're willing to make a bargain here. It's like, whoa, okay. They agree to keep the roads clear for the kingdom as people make their way to their compound. In exchange, they are offered access to the fair trade, to the fair to trade for supplies they need. And access to their movie projector. Who'd have thought, right? And it comes as a good time as Tara's group, including Earl and Tammy, keeping watch over the newborn Whisperer. Their horde of walkers comes after them, after their path is blocked by a fallen tree. So we got that going on over there. So I guess these highwaymen aren't really bad. Maybe they'll actually join them. I don't know. I have some thoughts about that. But anyway, and in the building, back in the building that Daryl's group is in, Henry gives Lydia a spear he made. Really, Henry? Oh, my God. And she reminds him she's not willing to kill her own people. So he takes him back and tells her he'll try not to either. What a sap. Wow. I'd have speared him with it. No doubt, my mind. Here. Lydia scolds him for risking his life for her, saying what he did make Alpha look weak. Not a good thing, as we all know. And then he reminds her he cares about her. Wah, wah, wah. And she kisses him. Daryl interrupts and tells them to keep watch. Throw them both out. I don't know. Throw Henry to him. Keep Lydia. A small horde of walkers approach Magna and Tara's group, of course. They get in position and remind themselves to watch for the Whisperers. Tammy puts the baby in a box with air holes and kills some walkers to save Earl. The highwaymen ride up suddenly on horses and introduce themselves to Tara as their escort to the fair. Then we're back to the building. Lydia spots a group of walkers and Whisperers as they emerge from the bushes toward the building. And of course, in the middle of the group is Beta. He quietly instructs his people to spread out as Daryl shoots one of them with his crossbow, of course. Beta and his people break in and quickly discover a trap meant to separate them from the dead. And you could hear him yelling, "It's a trap! It's a trap!" Oh, love his voice. Anyway, Beta avoids it, and Daryl makes Lydia hide in a closet. He locks her in as the Whisperers creep upstairs. Henry knocks one of them out. Connie slingshots another. They're just awesome, right? Henry's an idiot. Anyway, Daryl aims his crossbow at the main door, which gets busted down by Beta, who's using another door as a shield. Ooh, you gotta love him. I love him. He's great. Daryl regroups and kills a Whisperer through a sheet. Connie and Henry hunt down the others. And Lydia's in the closet, hearing her people getting killed, and she starts to break out of it. One of the Whisperers stabs Henry in the leg, but is then tackled by Daryl's dog. Oh, I love dog. Oh, I hope he survives it all. Connie finishes it off as Lydia breaks out and tells Henry it's okay. Okay. She breaks out of the closet to tell Henry that. Alrighty. Excuse me. Alrighty. And Daryl slits another Whisperer's throat and is bull rushed by Beta. And his size just kind of, if you look at Daryl's eyes, it's like, holy crap, you are big. And it's a great scene. The two size each other up. Beta forces Daryl's neck towards a blade. He manages to punch him and breaks free. Beta returns a punch of his own, and Daryl stabs him in the chest before escaping into the trap door. Beta grabs a knife out of his chest and says all he wants is Lydia. You see Daryl sneak up through the crawl space behind him. He rushes him and pushes him down the elevator shaft. He spits down on him and grabs his knife. That's a great scene. And that's the only thing really Daryl could do, because he'd have smushed him. Beta would actually make mincemeat out of him, actually. The highwaymen return to the kingdom with Tara and the others, who assure King Zeke and Carol they can be trusted. Apparently they were just, called the highwaymen because that's the only way they could get supplies. So, anyway, they greet Tara and ask where Henry and Daryl are. Tara admits she really thought they'd be there by now. And in the meantime, Daryl tells the others they're headed to Alexandria to get them fixed up because it's closer. As they leave, we zoom down to Beta lying at the bottom of the elevator shaft. Of course, he's alive. He, of course, gets up. He's in pain. He looks up. He's enraged and covered in blood. He's one pissed off whisperer. Not a cool thing to do. Totally crazy. Oh, you gotta love Beta though. Don't piss off him. Don't piss him off for sure. We have the highwaymen who are now friends of the kingdom. And at the beginning, Nabila walks with Carol surveying the fairgrounds of the kingdom. She says, after everything they've done to get to where they are, now there's no turning back. And of course, in that previous episode 3 weeks ago, King Zeke hoped that they finally reached a point in their lives where they no longer have to fight. And of course, we know what's eventually going to come for them in the upcoming episodes. You gotta love the trap they set for him. Because what they did, there's a secret space beneath the floor on the top level. The stairs have already been barricaded. So the trap was, if the whisperers come for them, they'll know who they are because walkers wouldn't be able to climb past them. So way to go. That was pretty ingenious. The trap does work. Why would she just come out of the breakout closet and tell Henry, it's okay. All right. And then Daryl and Beta. Awesome. It utilizes the setting, a deconstructed space with exposed foundation, sheets of cloth, and it creates a lot of effect tension. And of course, Beta proves he's fast and feral as Daryl. And Daryl goes through that hole in the wall. He kind of somersaults through it. Beta just goes right through it. He doesn't even bother with the hole. you got to love it. He can't really take him on head to head, so he does what he needs to do. With Henry injured, Daryl regroups and plans to go to Alexandria to stitch him up. He knows they can't stay there for long if the whispers track them there. Daryl's now warming up to Lydia. Whatever. I don't think it's a good idea. And says they can all keep running. They're going to have to. Beta did not die. So. And he's just ticked off in that hole. And with the fair going to formally kick it off, Carol, Ezekiel, and Tara are very much aware that Henry and Dale are not already there. With a few episodes left this season, the hope is that the Whisper War doesn't fall the way of the Negan War, which will hang on to next season. Alpha, don't let us down. We need to see this. That was episode 13. You gotta love it. And like I said, if you didn't know what they meant by guardians. It is the walkers. That's what the whisperers call them. They're guardians. So I thought that was kind of cool. That's an interesting outlook on that. But I don't think you want Beta pissed off at you, for sure. I wouldn't. I'd be like, whatever you need, dude. What did you think of this week's insane episode of The Walking Dead? Do you think Daryl's going to regret not finishing the job? And can the highwaymen be trusted? It seems like they can. Maybe they were just trying to survive like everybody else. And have you seen the next week's promo? What the hell? I don't know. It's so bizarre. I didn't even know what to say. I love this year's, the season 9 episode so far. Samantha Morton and Ryan Hurst. Wow, have you brought something to this show? It is amazing. I just love them both. I think they really needed a shot in the arm, and it's just wonderful. And of course, Lydia, she was in Castle Rock, in case you all didn't know. And I think towards the end of the season, winding down, we're going to get into some of these characters that we don't know and talk about them a little more. We don't have that many episodes left for this season. So, let's hope this gets a, gets going here on this show. Oh, nothing I'd rather see. Wonder what the cliffhanger is going to be, though. Okay, for those of you who don't want to hear of this, there's some spoilers. The Walking Dead, episode 14, Scars. So, if you don't want to hear it, now's the time to get off. I'll give you a minute. Okay, you gone? Okay. So, is there something in the future for Alpha and Daryl? Angela Kang teases that dangerous. It could be dangerous. They don't know. Showrunner teases the highwayman foe. Angela Kang reveals exactly what the new foes want from Hilltop. They were a little confused about, you know, the note left for them. For payment of use of the roads. And this payment was apparently for use of the roads around the local area, of course, which has already caused an issue for members of Hilltop. They're working hard for that, to get this fair going. But this demand for payment by the highwaymen is going to create a roadblock for all the communities. So the new foes are a little mysterious for now. Angela Kang recently spoke to Entertainment Weekly to discuss these brand new antagonists. And she explained they've got a giant obstacle they've got to deal with. And they don't know exactly what the script is like or how much danger they pose. So even the actors don't know how much danger the highwaymen pose. And she says there's going to be some action and excitement that comes out of this. So, and that's not all. Angela later alluded to the threatening note Carolyn and Ezekiel found. She hinted the group's solution to the parent roadblock may be surprising. Meanwhile, as the reign of the Whispers continues, the fans of the show have been eager to find out what ill fate is going to befall Alpha. Nothing, I don't think. She's been a tough match up against many of the characters on the show. She is one. She's a trip. They 50% of the viewers think that Alpha will go down the same road as Negan, and they'll have Negan finish Alpha off. So we'll see what happens with that. But another 28% of the voters believe Alpha is going to be killed by Lydia. I don't know if Alpha is going to die or not. It's certainly possible. But if that happens, what's Beta going to do? Or will Beta and Lydia overthrow Alpha? Lauren Cohen teases Maggie's return, of course, which I alluded at before. Is Negan going to take over? Negan's going to be playing a pivotal role, I think. I don't know. The leadership going on at the Hilltop's been a little sketchy, as we know. Daryl's even struggling. I don't know. They hint at a romance with Daryl. But who's it going to be with? Connie or Alpha? And I don't know if you noticed this, some of the books in Negan's cell are the same law books Michonne used to read, to study. So, recently, unfortunately, it was announced Michonne will be exiting the show after a 7-year stint on the show. I don't know. Is she going for good? We don't know. I don't know. But I think Michonne's just, I don't know what's going on with her. Whatever happened in that time jump in between there, and I know we're going to find out probably in the movies, but, again, somebody needs to be a leader in that group. But will it be Negan? Or will Michonne just be outed from the community? But it looks like Negan is going to play a pivotal role. I knew he was going to, and I'm not sure what. There's so much that could happen, so much. So, Daryl and Connie, maybe potential romance there. But will he be able to keep her safe if Negan takes over? How will he react if Negan takes over, being the man who killed both Glenn and Abraham? I don't know. Lots of crazy stuff could be going on here. So, we're going to leave it at that. I hate doing that. Crazy. And we'll find out what more is going to happen on Sunday, of course. So, if you're out there listening, please hit the like button so we know you're out there. We'd appreciate that. Join in the chat, too, if you would, please. Join the chat. We want to hear what you think. I want to hear what you think about these episodes so far. I love the Memorial to Shiva, though. Oh, that was an awe moment, and I loved it. It was great. That was so sad. But lots going on. Is Henry going to be... I hope he gets killed off. I'm sorry, but I can't... Oh, that whiny... Oh, and his hormones. Oh, we'll just run off somewhere. Good luck with that. Look what it's got you so far. People always rescuing your dead ass. I'm sorry, but... I can't, oh my God, I don't love disaster, but that's me. He wasn't worth risking, you know, that anything for. I'm sorry. If he wants Lydia, have her go. Have a good time. But again, you know, what's Lydia going to do? She doesn't want her people getting killed. She didn't like it. But on the other hand, is she going to side? You know, whose side is she on at this point? We don't know. So please join in the chat every Tuesday night for this discussion, okay? Really want to hear from you. Okay, that kind of wraps it up for tonight. I want to give a few shout-outs. Walking Dead Freak Show, of course. Hey, Michelle. And Jason Boyce. So there you go. Shout-outs. True Horror Junkies, Art of Darkness, King Parker Beyond, Horror Three Ring Circus, of course. Typhoid Mary's, because she lets me post there. So thank you, Mary, for that. I appreciate it. Survival Wolves with Mike Ronan. Planet B period O period B period on Facebook. With Michelle also. So and Conflicted with Julie Kinney, and it's What If Scenario. So check these pages out. I think you'll be pleasantly surprised. They are awesome. Also, you can listen to the shows on YouTube, KBLP LLC 4, the number 4, on YouTube. You can download these to your devices so to listen to later, so please do. You know, we'll look forward to talking to you next Tuesday for The Walking Dead. You gotta love it. Brought to you by King's Cannabiz, of course. So, that ends it for tonight. Y'all have a good night and rest of the week. Peace out, y'all.
You want to die?
No, I don't. But I will. It's gonna happen. If me dying could stop this, if it can make things different for us, for you, for all those other kids, it'd be worth it. I mean, was this the plan? Was it supposed to be this way? Is this who you want it to be? All you need to do is survive tonight. This is my show. You said it.
In a grave of roses, while the night is closing in, my soul is so cold. I know.
hotel, mapping out constellations of the place I know so well, sifting through the system for the piece that knows my name. Endlessly I list them in the master game. Welcome to my world. Are coming through. I'm riding on space junk, and it's bringing me to you. Bringing me to you. Through the 10th dimension to the certain. Beyond pre-millennial tension and the subatomic bomb, machine that spins within me and the spirit that drives me on, searching for an answer. Welcome to my world. Space junk is bringing me.